The scene you're watching now is taken from Hayao Miyazaki's Spirited Away. It comes in at about an hour and a half into the film, immediately following the film's most action-packed sequence. After defending Haku and being chased by the crazed No-Face through the bathhouse, Chihiro must go on one final quest to Swamp Bottom in the hopes of saving her dying friend Haku. The scene clocks in at around 2 minutes long and contains virtually no dialogue. For these 2 minutes, the story takes a backseat, and we are treated to the film's lush visuals and Joe Hisaishi's evocative soundtrack. Now, I'll be honest, this is my favorite scene in the whole movie. But even I have to ask, why? Why does this scene work so well? Most films nowadays seem to speed along at a breakneck pace, doing everything they can not to lose the audience's attention. So why does the train scene from Spirited Away just work? Well, Miyazaki attributes this to one thing, Ma. Ma is a Japanese word, which roughly translates to emptiness, a pause, or the space between two parts. You need to give the audience a chance to breathe, says Miyazaki. If you just have nonstop action with no breathing space at all, it's just busyness. When used correctly, scenes like this can amplify the moments of intensity and add to the viewer's engagement. This idea can be seen not only in Spirited Away, but across Miyazaki's filmography, and the results speak for themselves. But there's something else about the train scene that makes it special. When we are introduced to Chihiro at the start of the film, she is timid, whiny, and lazy. But as the film progresses, we get to watch Chihiro grow and develop naturally with every challenge she faces. Upon first entering the bathhouse, Chihiro is shown struggling with even the most basic of tasks, like descending a precarious set of stairs, or even washing the floor. By the time we get to the train scene, we've watched Chihiro face all of the character flaws from the beginning of the film. She has to stand up for herself in the face of adversity, and work hard in order to remain in the bathhouse. She manages things we wouldn't have thought possible from the Chihiro at the start of the film. As an audience, we don't really have a chance to reflect on this until Chihiro boards the train. As the franticness of the bathhouse gives way to the calm introspectiveness of the train, we finally get a good look at the new Chihiro. No longer is she selfishly thinking only of herself. She's risking everything to save a friend. The uncertain look in her eyes has been replaced by a look of determination. This scene has so much to offer. It builds out the world without defining anything concretely. It has an emotional resonance rivaled by few other scenes in the film, nor cinema as a whole. Its gentle nature and haunting beauty beg so many unanswered questions and work together to truly create a childlike sense of wonder. If there's one thing I hope, it's that more filmmakers take notes from Miyazaki's work. Don't be afraid of ambiguity. Giving the audience more questions than answers can be a good thing, and leave the audience with a chance to fill in the blanks for themselves, creating a more enriching experience. Most importantly, take your time and let the audience breathe. The payoff might just be better than you could imagine.